Welcome back to Forest Farms, everybody. I'm Ivan, and today we have a little Swiss beauty here. As you guys might know, the Swiss are pretty good at making chocolate, clocks, watches, those types of things, but they're also very good at making rifles. This is an old girl. This is a K11, which some of you guys might be familiar with, but I think more people are familiar with its brother, the K31, which was an improved version of this rifle, or maybe its older brother, the Schmidt-Rubin 1889. But this kind of marries the two, which I actually prefer visually, because it's got some of that old-fashioned late 1800s flair to it. Just the lines and where the magazine is placed and everything about it. But I just got it yesterday, and I'm excited to put it through its paces. I've been looking for one of these and lusting for some sort of Swiss rifle for years. But I'm kind of weird. I like to buy rifles in person so I can hold them. I could have ordered one, but I finally got one in my local gun shop, and I could not pass up the opportunity. But we'll do a little talking, a little shooting, but let's come down here. So as you guys might know, but some of you may not know, all of these Swiss rifles, whether it be the 1889 and its variants, the K11 and the K31, are all straight pull rifles. Has a camming surface on the inside of the bolt, which you can see it has kind of the neat, intricate bolt. But the camming surface in there enacts upon the camming surface that's cut into the receiver, and it locks it up safe, which makes it a pretty quick rifle and a very slick rifle to use. Here's the safety. You pull it, turn it like a key, locks it up. Once you pull it out, twist it again, you're good to go. It is good for if you had gloved hands, as if you were in the mountains in Switzerland. And, you know, just it kind of has this old-fashioned, real quality feel to it. So let's load it up. I got some PPU here, 174 grain soft points. That's all I could pick up where I am. I don't have any GP11. Yeah, I know that the GP11 is the preferred ammunition for these rifles. This is surplus stuff that's really good and accurate. But this is what I have, so this is what we're going to use. We have a target out there about 80 yards-ish. And I've only shot this rifle like less than 10 times, so we'll see what it does. But let's just get to it. Man, that hits hard, guys. Just the energy down at the target is a lot for this little round. And then the ejection just hit Thomas. It has a really positive ejection, too. And if you, and Thomas, I'm going to shoot this again, come over here and watch the trigger. It has like a very, very nice two-stage trigger where you pull it and you can feel a little wall, just very light. And then you just go past it and it goes off. Let's see if I can do it any justice. There's my wall. Boom. And I love the shape of the trigger, at least for my hand. It has this belly in it and this hook. And it just feels perfect. Once again, forward. I'll put it on safe to show you guys. Nothing. So let's bring it back, turn it. Believe that's in. Let's go for it again. Ah, it got away from me. I pulled the trigger before I was ready. Let's bring it back down. There it goes. And as you can see, locks on the last round on the magazine follower, so you know that you're out. And these rifles have a detachable box magazine. They loaded them with the chargers. They didn't just have a bunch of these sitting around. But it's still kind of cool. It makes it easy for cleaning and maintenance. And there it goes. Your sight system, you can see it. It walks its way. All the way up to 1,500 meters, which is a little bit, optimistic, I would think, for a rifle like this. But I could see maybe them wanting that if you're shooting from hillside to hillside in Switzerland. But also another weird thing, this is gonna be hot, but the barrels are free floated. You can see it moving. At least I believe that they're free floated. That's what it seems to me. And it's a very beautiful rifle. As you guys know, a lot of these rifles are pretty beat up looking, and people think, well, man, these things must have been drugged through some world wars or something, especially given the age. It's not so true. As most people understand, the Swiss were neutral during both world wars, and that's kind of how they play their game. They kind of have a militia army, and if you don't bother me, they don't bother you. So it's kind of a philosophy I think some people could understand, but just a wonderful, wonderful rifle. Let's load it up a couple more times, and I'll send you on your way. Okay. Like I said, these guns, 1, 2, 3, hold 6 rounds. Looks like I only got 5 rounds left. We were having some issues. As you guys seen in the last video, we got a new camera, but for some reason it's acting up on us today, so we're doing it with the old phone. But hopefully we can get the nice camera back into action, because I think that would be a really big improvement to our visual quality. Okay. There it is. Man, this thing's slick. It's smooth as butter. But that's kind of a first look, guys. Probably, I know it's a little bit of a short video, but at this wonderful Swiss K11, as you guys can see by the serial number, on the receiver, on the bolt, and on the magazine, it's an all-matching rifle. So that's kind of a nice thing, too. But I've been Ivan. We'll catch you next time on Forest Firearms.